Simon & Schuster Audio presents Big Bets: How Large-Scale Change Really Happens, by Rajiv Shah, read by the author.
To Shivam, with love, gratitude, and enthusiasm for our shared journey. And to Sajan, Amna, and Jaisal. Introduction: How to Avoid the Aspiration Trap. If you've picked up this book, you're drawn to the possibility of changing the world in a big, lasting way. That's good. The world needs changing. Humanity is facing perils at every turn. We're tearing each other apart, even as our planet teeters on the edge of catastrophe. And you can be the one to change it for the better. That you have that agency might come as a surprise. You may be skeptical that you have the might or the means to do big things. For centuries, two factors determined an individual's capacity for solving the world's problems: divinity and dollars. You could be a sort of living saint, a person empowered by some holy authority, or simply gifted with a genius for good and an otherworldly patience. Alternately, you could be a millionaire and then a billionaire, amassing or inheriting great wealth. If you were saintly or rich, you could then hope to transform the world by thought or action in your own lifetime or soon after. In more recent history, similar powers were given to countries' presidents or heads of state, as well as the leaders of large businesses. They often have outsized mechanisms to create sweeping change for vast swaths of people. You're likely not a saint who can suffer the hardships of living and working to improve lives in the world's poorest places. People like that are incredibly rare. Nor, I'm willing to bet, are you so rich you can write a check to solve the world's biggest challenges. After all, no one is. Climate change alone is a multi-trillion dollar problem. And president and prime minister aren't jobs that come open often or are won easily. The good news is you don't have to be a saint, a billionaire, or even a president to make big changes in the world. I'm living proof of that. I grew up in a middle-class family in suburban Detroit, sketching car designs in my school notebooks. It was the Motor City, after all, while facing immense pressure to become a doctor. I discovered when I was 22 that I wasn't cut out to be a saint, and when I was 44 that I was unlikely to become a billionaire. I made misstep after misstep trying to find my way in the world and help make it better. But with a mix of pluck and luck and a deep dedication to making a difference, I ended up working with teams that contributed to some of the biggest changes of the 21st century. We helped reduce preventable deaths by vaccinating nearly a billion children. We led programs to reduce hunger and famine by transforming farming communities in Africa. We organized huge relief and development campaigns in Haiti, Afghanistan, and across Asia. We helped lead a determined effort to end a horrible outbreak of Ebola in West Africa, and then later to combat the COVID-19 pandemic in the United States. At the same time, we have helped bring electricity to people previously denied the dignity of a simple light bulb. None of this was easy. If I make it seem so, it's a mistake of memory or writing. After all, these challenges were spiked with complexity and risk, and the measure of our success is uneven. There were times I failed, and in some cases, I'm still toiling away in hopes of progress. Still, along the way, I've seen that transformative change is possible if you embrace a certain way of thinking. In the pages ahead, you'll meet people who have done just that. None of them were real saints. A few were billionaires. One was president. But most were like you or me: thoughtful, dedicated, determined, and rarely the least bit sure at the beginning about what it would take to make a real difference. They blundered, took wrong turns, but put the failures behind them and kept moving forward. What set them apart was the big bet mindset. When faced with a problem and when in doubt, they pushed to solve rather than just improve. They didn't seek to better a few lives with charity or comfort. Instead, they set a huge, audacious goal: ending hunger, wiping out disease, transforming race relations. Though each of those challenges exists in some form today, I would argue that the change they achieved was far more sweeping because they set out to solve problems rather than settle for incremental improvements. By doing so, they avoided the aspiration trap. You can do the same. Anyone from intern to president in any organization, banks, government agencies, universities, or community groups, can benefit from the big bet mindset. This book will give you the knowledge and the tactics, and most important, the frame of mind, to tackle humanity's stickiest challenges. Let me show you how. Think of an extraordinarily tough challenge. Here's a non-exhaustive list to start the conversation. Billions of people are mired in poverty, suffering malnutrition, or living in communities that limit their dignity and access to opportunity. Democracy in many nations is under fire. Our very way of life is contributing to a climate crisis that's altering life on the planet and potentially making more of the world unlivable. Technology is changing our lives with inescapable speed, hurling us in directions that are both exciting and scary. The creeping feeling of helplessness you get listening to that paragraph is the aspiration trap beginning to close in on you. Would-be world changers too often get so caught up in a tough problem's complexities that they forget to seek and then address the root cause or core reason that a problem has gone unsolved. They worry about upsetting people on the way to real change, so they set their sights too low or are content to address only a small piece of the problem. They think there isn't enough money or support to achieve large-scale change, so they ask too little of others. Or they lose their way and fail to track results precisely enough to know whether their efforts are succeeding or falling short. The aspiration trap snares too many too often. It's the reason so many people have grown cynical, detached, or apathetic. It's the reason some people roll their eyes when you say, "We should end poverty," or "We can save our planet from the havoc we're causing." It's the reason that instead of going big enough, people settle for doing good enough. It's the reason that instead of seeking outright solutions for the root causes of the problems we face, many give aid or charity or make incremental improvements and then move on. A big bet mindset unlocks the dedication required to avoid the aspiration trap altogether. It raises your expectations for the scale of impact you can deliver. It prepares you for the long timeline required for real progress, seeing improvements as milestones on the way to lasting solutions. It helps you shoulder the intellectual challenge to determine a problem's root cause and what it will take to solve it. And it makes getting out of bed every morning invigorating and fun, because you're trying to make genuine progress on big, meaningful things. And it will help you conceive and carry out big bets for humanity. A big bet is a concerted effort to fundamentally solve a single pressing problem in your community or our world. Big bets require setting profound, seemingly unachievable goals and believing they are achievable. Big bets require finding a new way of thinking or doing things, often inspired by a technological advance or a novel method for harnessing the know-how, fortunes, and energies of others. Big bets require developing broad alliances, often among unlikely partners like government and business, that can summon sufficient resources and diverse capabilities to break through the constraints that so often limit social progress. And big bets require following through on measurable outcomes for as long as it takes for people and communities to benefit. You might be wondering, isn't this guy just naively idealistic or simply naive, as some have accused me of being in the past? Can big bets really pay off? Are there really enough individuals and institutions in the world ready to join alliances around big bets? Aren't most people just concerned about themselves? I've heard all those questions throughout the years. Questioning the motives or even the sanity of those seeking to make big change is easy. And today, doubt itself is a convenient refuge. Social media can be an open forum for gripes and sniping. Our politicians' words and actions and corporate executives' pay packages reinforce the prevailing cynicism. But I've also seen how setting bold aspirations and maintaining a commitment to solving our biggest problems can stir people to action. Time and again, I've seen how the quest to solve the world's biggest problems unlocks energy and enthusiasm and collaboration from all types of unlikely partners. They may not act when you say, "Would you like to help vaccinate a few kids you'll never meet in a country you'll never visit?" But their ears perk up, their ambitions stir, their hearts beat faster when you ask, "How would you like to ensure no child gets polio ever again?" Big matters. If you aspire to solve big problems, people, sometimes one by one, will join you. They will pull more than their weight. Sometimes they'll even perform unimaginable feats. The bigger your goals, the better your chances of bringing in sufficient partners, allies, and supporters to solve root causes and deliver large-scale change. It doesn't matter when the desire to try to change the world first strikes. Some people seem born with a mission, while others hear humanity's call far later in life. You don't need some elaborate life plan, or even your family's complete support, to join the fray. I was inspired to make the world better when I was 17, and that desire came by a twist of fate. Even then, and long after, I struggled to give that calling a firm direction and worried how it fit with the expectations that come with being the first child of.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.